Hello and welcome to the September edition of Sparrow News. Today we'll talk about a new collaboration, visit with a Sparrow superstar, check out what's new with the iSparrow EMR system, and so much more. So stay tuned. Sparrow and Mary Freebed Rehabilitation Hospital in Grand Rapids have formalized an agreement to strengthen and expand a long-standing practice of working together to provide rehabilitation care to patients. Both organizations are working together to establish joint protocols and increase collaboration between medical staffs to ensure rehabilitation patients receive the most appropriate level of care in a timely manner.
We have great respect for Mary Freebed. There's so much more that we could do for patients with rehab needs from an increasingly wide region. And if you're going to do that, why not look to a leader in rehab care throughout our state?
I think it's important to both organizations that the whole continuum of healthcare, so acute care and post-acute care, all the way to the end of that, whatever that outcome ultimately is going to be. And so for us to get together with a quality provider like Sparrow makes a lot of sense, because then we can be part of that continuum and the patient really is going to be the one to benefit from it.
Sparrow has a number of superstar caregivers who keep their eye on patient care. In this installment of our regular series, we visit with Dr. Susan Caldwell, a family practice physician at Sparrow Medical Group DeWitt.
Since 1999, I've been here in DeWitt. And it's really been my only practice. I went to school as an older medical student, had 5 children when I went to school.
Wow, that's a lot of work.
I think medical school is a cakewalk compared with raising kids. And I've taken them all on medical mission trips to volunteer in Honduras and Haiti. We just finished one down to Honduras in May, and we took 12 or 13 Sparrow employees with us. We took some pharmacists, and I only had 2 physicians, and I had 8 nurses, and in a week we saw 1,500 patients down there because of the incredible strengths that the nurses brought to it. They were seeing patients right alongside of us and could not have done it without them. We saw a lot of sick people down there. I'm fascinated by my practice. I love coming to work every day, and I love my patients. I look on them as friends, and I try to think of them every day as, how would I want to be treated? How would my family members want to be treated if they went to a doctor's office? How would we want to be taken care of? I feel very blessed to have a wonderful office with wonderful patients, and I just feel like I'm in a very good place.
Throughout the year, there are many opportunities for Sparrow caregivers and their families to participate in events that not only support Sparrow, but the communities we serve. And there are 2 great upcoming events that you will not want to miss.
The first one is the 8K, 5K, OK run. The OK part of it is if you don't like to run, the OK part means that you can come over to Sparrow up on the Cancer Center parking lot area. And we have people that do massage, that do reflexology, that do manicures, pedicures, the other parts of healthy living that sometimes that we neglect. And of course, then for the runners, it's just a marvelous opportunity to go through this neighborhood in this area.
And the one after that is called the Hike for Hospice?
Hike for Hospice is a different type of venue. And I guess the best thing I can say about this is that it's a celebration of life. It really is a time to think about people who we've lost and reflect on their lives and to celebrate their lives.
Be sure to stop by sparrow.org/Sparrow Foundation and click on events to register or find out more information. And here are some more special events coming up in the next few weeks. Our commitment to quality care extends beyond our patients to include our caregivers as well. This year, open enrollment for Sparrow benefits begins sooner in early October. It's an opportunity for caregivers to review and make changes to their health and other benefits for the upcoming year. Changes take effect on January 1st, 2013. For more information, call the Total Rewards hotline at 517-364-5333. In an effort to create a safer environment for patients and caregivers, Sparrow is working proactively to combat seasonal influenza. So how is Sparrow preparing everyone for the flu season?
We're going to be vaccinating not only ourselves as caregivers, but encouraging and assessing our patients for vaccinations also.
The other part of that is, too, they're already here with a health condition, and so encouraging them to protect themselves in any way possible so that they're not contracting the flu on top of what they're already here for. So we just encourage them to protect themselves and their families.
Beginning this year, assessing patients for flu vaccination and administrating it accordingly is required to meet inpatient immunization core measures. Over the past several months, we've talked about the launch of the iSparrow EMR system on December 1st, 2012. Now we'd like to let you know that there's even more assistance to help get ready from iSparrow EMR super users.
We will be teaching our super users the applications specific to their area of expertise. So if a nurse wants to be a super user and she's working in the ER, we're going to train her for the ER application so that she can provide that elbow-to-elbow support for her caregivers that she works with and her colleagues on an everyday basis.
Super users who begin training in September are crucial to the success of the iSparrow EMR project. Sparrow is now making it easy for caregivers to connect their Sparrow email accounts with their personal smartphones or tablets. Here's Tom Brez, Vice President and Chief Information Officer, to tell us more.
We're really excited about this new program because it allows our caregivers to take advantage of more and new and different types of mobile devices to connect to their email and their calendaring, but they don't have to carry multiple devices anymore. They can have a single device. It can be the device that they choose. It doesn't have to be a BlackBerry. It can be an iPhone. It can be an Android device. And for the individuals who have had Sparrow BlackBerries before or whose job it really is required that they have mobile access, then there still will be a monthly allowance, a mobile allowance, but we're making the connection available to anyone.
For complete instructions on how to link your personal devices, visit sparrow.org/mobile-access. Well, that wraps up the September edition of Sparrow News. Thanks for watching, and be sure to join us next month when we bring you more news from Sparrow.